Hi everybody, I hope you're having a great day. In this video, I'm going to be covering who I call Viking Venom. Now, he made his first appearance in Venom, Volume 4, Issue Number 13, that was released in April of 2019. This being also goes by the name Magic Venom, and of course, the underlying host is Eddie Brock, who, although in his human form stands 6 feet 3 inches tall and weighs 260 pounds, having blonde hair and blue eyes, when he's enhanced as this artificial iteration of Venom, he initially bared a striking resemblance to the typical Clintar form, although his body was covered in crystal-like spikes as well as Nordic runes. And of course, since this form had shape-shifting abilities, it had variable height and weight. Now, on this occasion, Eddie was empowered by a dark elf mystical artifact known as a Dreamstone. This device manifests the desires of those that wield it. And in Eddie's case, it was particularly tuned to manifest anything that could be a weapon for him. And although at this time, Eddie didn't have the classic Clintar Venom symbiote, the Dreamstone accessed his memories and obviously manifested all of the information it had about the Venom symbiote, creating a simulacrum that had all of its powers and abilities, which is perfectly adapted for Eddie's use. Viking Venom had vast superhuman strength, durability, speed, agility, and stamina, while also possessing wall crawling and a moderate to advanced healing factor. Now, some unique abilities is that it could not only shapeshift and have constituent matter generation from some of its tendrils, this Dreamstone-created magical venom could also manifest pure weapons, such as swords and axes, at times even showing that it could evolve on its own in response to Eddie's needs, despite Eddie's lack of imagination. In one of its most impressive feats, this symbiote actually emulated the powers of Thor, showing that it could conjure a thunderstorm and actually send lightning strikes at foes. The only weaknesses that this symbiote displayed is that its first form inherited the template's vulnerability to flames, although it did eradicate this weakness once it quickly attained its third form. And the villainous nature of this dark elf-created construct tended to feed off of purely negative emotions like rage, yet was weakened by emotions like love. Now, this all started when one of Malekith's war witches, who seek to corrupt noteworthy mortals, turning them into servants of chaos, offered Eddie Brock a Dreamstone that could give him massive power. At this point, Eddie did not have his Venom symbiote, and cunningly accepted the offer, knowing that he couldn't truly protect his son Dylan if he was just a normal human. Once the Dreamstone accessed Eddie's memories and desires, Viking Venom was born, making it his very first point to immediately turn on the witch and bite her arm off, which made her quickly retreat. Eddie would instruct his son to stay hidden and would then set out to use his newfound power to take part in the War of the Realms, trying to fight to protect the innocent from Malekith's invasion. Eddie would soon realize, though, that this new Viking Venom suit was feeding off of and amplifying all of his negative emotions, making it very easy for him to possibly lose control and go into a berserker rage. Viking Venom wouldn't be long into his campaign until he was confronted by a Dreamstone-augmented jack-o'-lantern, along with 3 powerful frost giants. Come to find out, the war witch that he betrayed presented his enemy jack-o'-lantern with a Dreamstone of his own, offering him a sweet chance at revenge. Being presented with these overwhelming odds, Eddie decided to overload his symbiote with negative emotions, giving him the ability to fight the frost giants. But when he was attacked by Jack-O-Lantern's new flaming power, the natural weakness of the Venom symbiote was exploited. But the suit would then evolve itself into a second venomized suit of Asgardian armor. As these 2 supercharged enemies would continue their fight, the Viking Venom armor would evolve again, becoming even more powerful and streamlined, and even augmenting a battle axe that Eddie had. This latest form was even shown to be able to give pieces of itself to bond to other individuals in the crowd, giving these civilians enough power to fight back as they escaped. And to subsequently set it all off, this is when the Viking Venom evoked the powers of Thor, calling down a massive lightning strike to beat Jack-O-Lantern and summoning up this thunderstorm to put out all the flames that had spread. Yet despite all of these amazing powers that were displayed, Eddie would make the wise decision to give up his Dreamstone rather than let his anger and rage control him and make him into an agent of chaos, just as the Dark Elves would have wanted. Now, for his considerable powers and abilities, and his brief influence on the Marvel Universe, for my 1 to 10 rating, I'll give Viking Venom a rating of 8, which is an unforgettable rating. I hope everyone enjoyed this video. I'll talk to you next time. Be sure to like, subscribe, and join the New Sage.